Hello viewers, in this lesson we shall try to understand the patent system, a conceptual analysis. The objectives of this lesson are to understand the concept of patents, to trace the historical evolution of patent protection, to distinguish different kinds of patents from each other, to analyze the subject matter of patent protection, and to examine the international and national laws relating to patent protection. Viewers, by now you must be aware that intellectual property rights are the rights awarded by society to individuals or organizations, principally over creative works, inventions, literary and artistic works and symbols, names, images and designs used in commerce. They confer on the creator the right to prevent others from making unauthorized use of their property for a limited period. Intellectual property is classified as industrial property and literary property, though the current technological developments are blurring this distinction to some extent in view of the emergence of new forms of intellectual property rights. When we look at the various forms of industrial property, it can be seen that patents occupy a central place in such broad classification. Patents. A patent is an exclusive right awarded to an inventor to prevent others from making, selling, distributing, importing or using their invention without license or authorization for a fixed period of time. In return, the government requires that the patent applicant disclose the invention in a manner that enables others to put it into practice. Thus, it is a kind of quid pro quo system, whereunder the inventor gets certain exclusive rights in the form of monopoly in lieu of parting with the details of the invention, which satisfies a requirement of novelty, utility or industrial applicability and non-obviousness that determine the patentability of an invention. Disclosure of the invention increases the body of knowledge available for further research. Utility models are similar to patents, but in some countries confer rights of shorter duration to certain kinds of small or incremental innovations. By conferring temporary market exclusivities, patents allow procedures to recoup the costs of investment in research and development and reap a profit in return for making publicly available the knowledge on which the invention is based. However, someone else can only put that knowledge to potential commercial use with the authorization of the patentee. Protection is therefore a bargain struck by society on the premise that in its absence there would be insufficient invention and innovation. This rationale for patent protection is relatively straightforward, but it is dependent on a number of simplifying assumptions that may not be borne out in practice. For instance, the optimal degree of patent protection cannot be accurately denied. If protection is too weak, then the development of technology may be inhibited through insufficient incentives for R&D. If too much protection is conferred, consumers may not benefit even in the long run, and patentee may generate profits far in excess of the overall costs of the research and development. Thank you. Now, let us look at the historical evolution of the patent system. The modern patent system dates back to the year 1421, when Florence in Italy granted the first recorded patent to Filippo Brunelleschi for the design and use of a ship, the Badalone, meaning sea-going monster. The Badalone, intended to ferry supplies up the Arno River to the city for the building of the Florentine Cathedral Dome, which Brunelleschi was the designer of. Badalone sank during delivery of a load of white marble intended for use in constructing the dome. The Venetian Senate passed the first patent law in 1474, granting limited duration monopoly for original devices. This law embodied the principles of patent protection as we know them today. In England, in 1449, King Henry IV granted the country's first patent for stained glass manufacturing. In England during this time, a patent was a government granted monopoly, so could be as much a right to manufacture or trade as well as the right to deny others to do so. The present day patents were called the monopolies in England and other countries. The Statute of Monopolies was an act of the Parliament of England, notable as the first statutory expression of English patent law. Patents evolved from letter patent issued by the monarch to grant monopolies over particular industries to skilled individuals with new techniques. Originally intended to strengthen England's economy by making it self-sufficient and promoting new industries, the system gradually became seen as a way to raise money through charging patent holders without having to incur the public unpopularity of a tax. Elizabeth I particularly was a great abuser of the system, issuing patents for common commodities such as starch and salt. Unrest eventually persuaded her to turn the administration of patents over to the common law courts, but her successor James I was even more abusive. Despite a committee established to investigate grievances and excesses, Parliament made several efforts to further curtail the monarch's power. The result was the Statute of Monopolies passed on 25th May 1624. In the United States, the governmental right to grant patents was enshrined in the Federal Constitution in Article 1, which empowered the US Congress to promote the progress of science and useful arts by securing for limited times to authors and inventors the exclusive right to their respective writings and discoveries. The first US Patent Act was in 1790. Throughout US history, the rigor of patent examination has varied widely, from literally granting every patent applied for to very strict examination. Probably it is only after the signing of the Paris Convention for Protection of Industrial Property in 1883 that the patenting system got strengthened all over the Europe and other countries. Now, let us look at general principles applicable to working of patented inventions. The philosophy of patenting and working of patented inventions is very appropriately reflected in Section 83 of the Patents Act 1970. It is equally relevant to the modern patent system in other countries also. The patents are granted to encourage inventions and to secure that the inventions are worked on a commercial scale and to the fullest extent that is reasonably practicable without undue delay. They are not granted merely to enable the patentees to enjoy a monopoly for the importation of the patented article. The patenting system is expected to ensure that the protection and enforcement of patent rights contribute to the promotion of technological innovation and to the transfer and dissemination of technology, to the mutual advantage of producers and users of technological knowledge, and in a manner conducive to social and economic welfare and to a balance of rights and obligations. In modern times, there is an increasing awareness that patents granted should not impede protection of public health and nutrition, and should act as instruments to promote public health, especially in sectors of vital importance for socio-economic and technological development of the country. The modern governments are preserving their power to take effective measures to protect public health while granting patents. Similarly, it is also equally important to ensure that the patent right is not abused by the patentee or person deriving title or interest on patent from the patentee by resorting to practices which unreasonably restrain trade or adversely affect the international transfer of technology. The patents are generally granted subject to the condition that the benefit of the patented invention is made available at reasonably affordable prices to the public. Now, let us have a look at the classification of patents. Patent protection encompasses different forms like process patent, product patent, utility models, inventor certificates, and patents of addition. The concept of each of them is as under. Process patent. It is a type of patent reserved for manufacturing processes in which a material is treated in a certain manner in order to change its characteristics or functionality for a particular application. The holder of a process patent has been granted the exclusive use of that particular manufacturing process and is not vested with the monopoly in respect of the end product manufactured by using such process. The implication is that any other person can produce the same product through some other process modifying different parameters. Weakness of the process patent is that it gives lesser protection to the patentee, as there is every possibility of reverse engineering by other producers of the same end product. For instance, under the Patents Act of 1970, only process patents were granted to inventions relating to food, chemicals, and pharmaceuticals till the TRIPS agreement was fully complied with on 1st January 2005. Product patent. In this kind of patent, the protection is given in respect of the end product itself. It is an exclusive right given to the original inventor of a product. In other words, no other manufacturer can produce the same product through the same or any other process. There will be no competition to the manufacturer, as it is the product which is patented. Such patents grant greater monopoly to the patentee. TRIPS agreement mandates in its Article 27 Clause 1 that patents shall be available for any inventions, whether products or processes, in all fields of technology, provided that they are new, involve an inventive step, and are capable of industrial application. Utility models. A utility model is an intellectual property right to protect inventions. This right is available in more than 70 countries like Australia, Japan, and Germany. It is very similar to the patent, but usually has a shorter term, often 6 to 15 years, and less stringent patentability requirements. The rights conferred by utility model laws are very similar to those granted by patent laws, but are more suited to what may be considered as incremental inventions. Terms such as petty patent, innovation patent, minor patent, and small patent may also be considered to fall within the definition of utility model. It is also called the second tier of patent protection. India doesn't grant this kind of patents. Inventor's certificates. It denotes a form of inventor's recognition formerly available in the Soviet Union and a number of socialist countries. Also called author certificate. Such certificates granted by the government acknowledged the true and first inventors after such inventions were taken over from them. A token amount of royalty was also paid to such inventors. This is legacy of the existence of only public property in certain communist countries in the past. Patents of addition. Where the invention is already protected by a patent, the improvement or modification over the original patented product or process may be protected by a patent of addition in India and some other countries. A patent of addition enables the applicant to apply for an improvement or modifications made on the invention disclosed in the complete specification. The improvement must be something more than a mere workshop improvement. The term for a patent of addition shall not exceed the term of a regular patent and shall not be granted prior to the date of grant of patent for the main invention. This provision of patent of addition in India, New Zealand, and Australia is in conformity with that of continuous in part application under the American patent system. Sections 54, 55, and 56 of the Patents Act 1970 in India deal with the patents of addition. International patent classification. It may be noted that the above discussion is relating to the nomenclature used in the sphere of patents. For the purpose of determining novelty and prior art, we may refer to the International Patent Classification used to classify patents and utility models according to the different areas of technology to which they pertain. The International Patent Classification was established by the Strasbourg Agreement in 1971 and is continuously revised by the International Patent Classification Committee of Experts. The International Patent Classification is a hierarchical patent classification system used in over 100 countries to classify the content of patents in a uniform manner. Each classification term consists of a symbol such as A0, 1B, 1/00, which represents hand tools. The first letter is the section symbol consisting of a letter from A, that is human necessities, to H, that is electricity. This is followed by a 2-digit number to give a class symbol. For instance, A01 represents agriculture, forestry, animal husbandry, trapping and fishing. The final letter makes up the subclass. For instance, A01B represents soil, working in agriculture or forestry, parts, details or accessories of agricultural machines or implements in general. The subclass is then followed by a 1-3-digit group number, an oblique stroke and a number of at least 2 digits representing a main group or subgroup. A patent examiner assigns a classification to the patent application or other document at the most detailed level which is applicable to its contents. Now, let us look at what can be patented, that is the patentable subject matter. Patents protect inventions. The inventions could be in the form of either a product or process. As per Article 27, Clause 1 of the TRIPS Agreement, patents shall be available for any inventions, whether products or processes, in all fields of technology, provided that they are new, involve an inventive step, and are capable of industrial application. In this context, new denotes novelty, which means that there is no prior art relating to such invention. Inventive step, also called non-obviousness, denotes that the invention reflects something more than the existing knowledge or technology in the field, which improves the economic value of the invention. Industrial application denotes that the invention sought to be patented is capable of being used and produced in an industry. It is also known as utility in some countries. Consequently, discoveries are incapable of patent protection. Similarly, all inventions are also not entitled to patent protection, as the nations are required to exclude certain inventions from patentability in the interest of protecting public order, morality and health, apart from environmental protection. One can refer to Article 27, Clause 2 of TRIPS Agreement and also to Sections 3 and 4 of the Patents Act 1970 of India in this context. Term of patent protection. Till the TRIPS Agreement mandated, all the member countries of the WTO, there was no uniformity as to the term of patent protection. For instance, it was 17 years in USA and 14 years in India. Now, the term has been fixed at 20 years in all these countries. Legal regime of patents. At the international level, the following conventions, treaties and agreements govern the patent system in many countries. They are the Paris Convention for the Protection of Industrial Property 1883, the Patent Cooperation Treaty 1970, the Strasbourg Agreement of 1971 on International Patent Classification, the European Patent Convention 1973, and the Budapest Treaty on the International Recognition of the Deposit of Microorganisms for the Purpose of Patent Procedure 1977, etc. In India, the first patent law was made in 1856. It was repealed in 1857 and substituted with a new act in 1859. It was consolidated in 1872 to provide protection relating to designs and was renamed as the Patents and Designs Protection Act of 1872. It was further amended in 1883 to introduce a provision to protect novelty of the invention, which prior to making application for their protection were disclosed in the Exhibition of India. A grace period of 6 months was provided for filing such applications after the date of the opening of such exhibition. This act remained in force for about 30 years without any change until it was amended in 1888 to bring it in conformity with the Patent Law of United Kingdom. The Indian Patents and Designs Act 1911 replaced all the previous acts and brought patent administration under the management of Controller of Patents for the first time. After independence, it was felt desirable to enact comprehensive patent law owing to substantial changes in political and economic conditions of the country. Accordingly, the Government of India constituted a committee under the chairmanship of Justice Dr. Bakshi Tek Chand, a retired judge of Lahore High Court, in 1949 to review the patent law in India in order to ensure that the patent system is conducive to the national interest. The committee submitted its interim report on 4th August 1949 with recommendations for prevention of misuse or abuse of patent rights in India. The committee also observed that the Patents Act should contain clear indications to ensure that food and medicine and surgical and curative devices are made available to the public at the cheapest price commensurate with giving reasonable compensation to the patentee. Based on the above recommendations of the committee, the 1911 Act was amended in 1950 in relation to working of inventions and compulsory license and revocation. Other provisions were related to endorsement of the patent with the words license of right on an application by the government so that the controller could grant license. In 1952, an amendment was made to provide compulsory license in relation to patents in respect of food and medicines, insecticide, germicide or fungicide, and a process for producing substance or any invention relating to surgical or curative devices. In 1957, the Government of India appointed Justice N. Rajagopal Iyengar Committee to examine the question of revision of the patent law and advise government accordingly. The report of the committee recommended major changes in the law, which formed the basis of the introduction of the Patents Bill 1965, which however lapsed. In 1967, again an amended bill was introduced, which was referred to a joint parliamentary committee, and on the final recommendation of the committee, the Patents Act 1970 was passed. This act repealed and replaced the 1911 Act so far as the patents law was concerned. However, the 1911 Act continued to be applicable to designs. Most of the provisions of the 1970 Act were brought into force on 20th April 1972 with publication of the Patent Rules 1972. This Act remained in force for about 24 years without any change till December 1994. After India had signed the TRIPS agreement, it was amended three times in 1999, 2002 and 2005. The important changes made by these amendments were as follows. By way of amendment of the Act in 1999 with effect from the 1st January 1995, mailbox for pharmaceutical and agrochemical products and exclusive marketing rights were provided. By way of the 2002 amendment with effect from the 1st January 2000, patent term was increased to 20 years, definition of invention was enlarged to include inventive step, reversal of burden of proof to shift it to the infringer, mandatory compulsory license, the license of right, provision for food, drugs and chemicals was removed and rights of patentee got enlarged to include the right to import. By way of the 2005 amendment with effect from the 1st January 2005, product patents for food, chemicals and pharmaceuticals were reintroduced. Thus, we have met our commitments under the TRIPS agreement and became fully compliant with the same. Viewers, after going through this lesson, you must have become conversant with the concept of patents, emergence of the patent system, the purpose of the patent system, the kinds of patents granted, the patentable subject matter, and the international and Indian law relating to patents. I hope that you have enjoyed this lesson. I hope to see you in the next lesson. Thank you.